I'm Ranger Kooky. Today is, I'm going to my Molle 2, the digital camera Molle. I just got a new bag and I like the new bag more than the old bag because it looks like it has more bag capacity. And I'm going to give and take bag. So you get to see me take out my stuff that I usually use for this bag. It's my car camping bag. You know, park your car like right now and throw all your camping gear out. That's basically what car camping is all about. This is my car camping bag. So I'm going to take everything out and add it to my new Molle system. This is the Molle 2, if I'm not mistaken. And I got, it has better, bigger bags on this thing. So we're going to do some trading. I'm going to trade my my stuff that's in this bag into this bag because they got bigger bags. And I got some more bags over there to add on to the Molle 2. So come on. All right, here's my bush chair. The amazing bush chair. This is for old people. Come down. Look at me. Watch this. Watch how cool this is. This is my, I call it the bush chair because you can sit anywhere with this. And this is for these old timers like me. Need that back support. Yeah, I good back support. I can almost lean back and enjoy a nice relaxing view of the sunset at Fountain Blue State Park. It comes in two colors, black and green. And that's my bush chair. I always bring that everywhere with me. Because you never know when you need to sit down. I can sit down right on the ground and it won't get my ass wet or cold or whatever it is. And I have that back support. You know, you might be able to hang it up in a tree and sit on it. I don't know. I never tried it. It might break, you know, the straps. But you never know. All right, this is my bush chair. I had a giveaway for this bush chair. If y'all say I like to have one, let me know. I do a giveaway too, if y'all think I should. Okay, enough of that. All right, the Molle 2. What's in my Molle 2 that everybody else? Okay, I got a very heavy duty poncho, which I also use as a tarp, because it's pretty big. I use it as a tarp to protect myself from the rain and elements. Like an army poncho, but it's blue. I don't know why. Oh yeah, I forgot. I found this in the trash. I love when people throw away. Yeah, rich folks throw away good stuff like that. Probably threw it away because they didn't know what it was. I don't know. All right, got my poncho and tarp. If I want to use it as a tarp, that goes into my new mod. Right on top, so I can grab this thing if it starts raining and put it on immediately with no problem. All right, in my Molle 2, I have a small, I got a little pocket knife. I keep that one of the Molles because it fits right on there. So let's see if I can put that back on my other bag in the same spot I had that one. And I have a small, you can't see that, over here.
Okay, there you go.
And on my bag, I always carry a little small flashlight. You never know, that little flashlight just good enough to see what's in your bag. You don't need a big monster 200 amp light bulb to see what you're doing. Especially going in your bag, you just going in your bag. You don't need a monster light. So I'm gonna take my flashlight off. I'm taking everything out this bag because this one has the, I could just take the bags off of that one, but you know what? This one we'll do. I'm going to just take the bags off of that one and put it on here. What a retard. Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and I'm out here. I'm working on my Molle, too. I'm going to add some new pouches to it to make it more heavy. Oh, yeah. I love that weight, I guess. All right, I just got a Molle 2 here. And I'm going to take off two pouches and add to my other Molle. This is my car camping video. Car camping Molle. So I'm ready to add all kinds of goodies in this thing. I like the Velcro strips that's in here. This is my Molle 2. I'm ready to take off a couple bags and add a bag to it. So let's get to it. But first, let's find out what's in the Molle. I have my hammock, a small bag with my belts for my hammock, fleece blanket. That goes in the bottom and my sleep system. It's in a waterproof bag, so if I do get wet, my blankets won't get wet. Remember, a good night's sleep means a lot to some people. Alright, on the side, I have the Time Clipwood knife I got from them. Over here, I have an emergency blanket, which I probably don't need, but still got it. My mosquito control in its refilling package. Put it in this little case. I have a miniature saw, just in case I need a saw at the campsite. I have a saw to cut wood. Thing about Molle, all that weaving you gotta do, all the belts and stuff they got on these things. Here is my food pouch. You know how I eat my food. On this side, this is the bag I gotta take off. This is my cook kit. And get this stuff done. See me struggling, it's not funny. This is the bag I had on to the side. This is not the right bag. This is really a bag that goes around your fat ass. I guess, but I'm gonna find another use for this bag. I'm taking it off. Then we'll add this bag and this bag to my other Molle. Alright, I'll see you in a few minutes. I'll show you where I'm eating. Look, everybody! A naked Molle! It's naked! I took all of its clothes off! So this is what naked Molle looks like after you take all his clothes off. Look how deep that thing is. Yeah, the reason why I'm doing that is checking for bees. Alright. Make sure you check, make sure you, which way is your bag before you put the sucker upside down. Your mom would be beating you. So what you want to do is find out where you want it. It goes through like so. And it goes into this belt latch right here. I guess that keep your food from running away. Then do the same thing on the bottom. Take and loop it. This one's a loop by the bottom. I guess this is to keep your food from really running away from you. Or in case you want to put a mat here, you could put a mat. You could have put the straps underneath your bag, or you put it on top. I recommend to put it on the bottom, but that's me. I have no reasons to hold it down that hard. So what I'm going to do, I think this is the correct way, but I'm going to take this, because this is probably for your mat. I'm going to run underneath this. I'm going to run it through the slot. Run it through the other slot. And run it through the belt loop. Because I think it's compressing the food pouch, so you can't put much food in there, or whatever you're compressing, keep it from holding a lot of room. So I'm just going to put it underneath and look professional. It's all tapered up and you can't see the belt. I'm going to do the same thing with the bottom one. I think it's compressing the bag for the potentials where it's supposed to be really used for. So I'm just going to go underneath and make it more professional looking. Go underneath. Oh, come on, damn you, boy! Oh, there she is. Oh. Find out where you want your bag to be. What you want to do, you got to weave your mollies. There's what these little belts and mollies are for. You got to weave it one through the other belt on the bag, then through the other weave, then snap it. There you go. Then you do the same thing here. And you do it again. And you do it again. You gotta weave it in so it stays to your bag and it's not gonna rip. Alright, and once again, do the top first, maybe. Don't quote me on that because I don't know. Over. So what you're gonna do is weave it into the other belt. And weave it in the other belt. And snap. Now this could be my food ration bag or my just equipment, whatever equipment I want to put in there, my cook kit, my whatever is on me and me can put in there. And snap. There we go. One bag done. I'm gonna close that up so I can. Oh yeah, and there's a belt that runs. Supposed to run through this part right here, not underneath, inside that little loop. Anybody want to buy a GoPro cam? Because my GoPro is turning me to a piece of shit. Alright, I could put this one in the middle, and I have all these new bags I just got yesterday. Because I went to go hunt for Dolly Polanini for some new bags. And I found some new bags and some stuff that he required or asked me to get for him. I hope there's no bees underneath my horsey. Alright, look at all these cool bags I got. This one's a zipper, goes all the way. Come down, look at the bags. Now, that's a cool bag. I don't know what it is. I only paid $9 for it. Usually these things are about $100. This one's only $12. This one is $7. $8. $10. $10. And this was $99. And $12. See, here's the tag for it. $99. That was for the whole body. Alright, so I want to try to put two of these bags on it. See, here's a question. What bag is this for? Look at how dumb this is. Okay, I can see. Alright, look. There's your zipper. Okay, there's your zipper. Now, here's your mollies to put stuff on or add it to a bag, right? Now, here's the mollies for this one, and the zipper is right here, right? Okay. This one's clamped, that's simple. And same with this one, the zipper's right here, and the molly's in the back. Now look at this one. The opening is where the molly's at. So here's the question, what goes on this thing that molly's go in the zipper? Asking me that, answer that question. I'm puzzled about that. Okay, I guess, I don't know, I'm puzzled. Alright, so we got all these mollies. Alright, I'm going to make a I'm gonna put these two together to make a little super pouch. So I might not put that on the Molle. I do want to put my saw back on, so let's find a spot for that. Okay, that's wrong. Is this wrong? Nope, that one's weave right. Don't look like it. Yeah, this one's weave right, so this is done right. Let's take a look at this one. Oop, I don't have one over here, so that's good. All right. Checking the weaves. Make sure your weaves are done right when you're back. All right, we have to put. Now I could put, instead of putting it in the front, I could put it on the side. Right? I could do that. This is my bag. Everybody's different. Remember that. Everybody's different. Everybody has different opinions about different things, how they want to put stuff. So bear with me. This is my bag. It's my way. The way I like it to put things. You could put your bag the way you want to put it. So I'm just going through my Molle 2, showing you what the bags are. Oh, some of the stuff is in the bags. There's not much in this bag. But everybody's different. Everybody wipes their butt different. Same ways, everything else. I'm a different individually, so I'm going to put things different than you. So knowing that, let's go on. All right. We got all these cool camouflage, digital camouflage. We gotta put this one back because that's my saw. That one has to go back. Now, I do want to make a cook kit. Now, this was only $8, so that's why I took it, because it was only $8 and it's the only one I had. So I'm like, hey, it's a bag for $8. You can't beat that. So I took it. So I need a cook kit. Bag should I use as a cook kit? I'm missing a bag, am I? Is I? Where is it? Where's that long one I had? Excuse me. I look for a bag. Oh, there it is. It's really there. This is the one I had my cook kit in. Let's find out why. It fit perfect. And my gas and my two cups, and it's perfect. Look at that, nice size. It has all kinds of pretty straps on it, but I want to see if I can get and put that in one of these bags I put on the side like this. Put my cook kit in this bag. That's one we do. All right, what we do now? I might as well put this bag on the bottom. And that'd be my cook kit bag. Alright, let's see. Let's take a look. I'm taking a little break, a little water break. And my food rations on top, or my cook kit on top, and my food rations on bottom, or whatever I want. What's on my mind? Where do I want the weight? Do I want it on top? Do I want it on the bottom? So we have to do a test. They say having the weight at the bottom or in the middle helps out, but everybody's different. Everybody thinks different too. So, all right, let's put this on. Weave in, weave out, and weave in. Look down, look at me. Look what I'm doing. There we go. And snap. Then come down. And oh shit. This might compress my bag. I don't know if I want to compress my bag. Because moving these up where they don't belong tightens the bag up, so your bag will be compressed. You don't want a compressed bag. You want it to be relaxed, open. Let's take a look. Yeah, look, it's got like a compression here. See that? Do you really want that? Do I have to go down? Then it won't be weaved. Do I have to go up? Can I go up? Yes, let's go up one. Because you don't want to be compressed. It's not a compression bag. You want that thing to be... There we go, like that. See the difference? Damn, big difference. Okay, let's go to the top one. Weave in. Weave out. Mama, don't bite me if I do it wrong again. Mama, don't bite me, Mama. Alright, now. Now my bag is not compressed like it was. It's much opener. Opener, Lacey, to me, much, much opener. Opener. Alright, I guess. Weave in. Weave out. Up a little bit. There we go. Weave in. See, a little while ago, it was compressed. It was like this. You don't want to compress your bag. You want to be open as much as you can. Weave in. Weave out. Just like a basket. You want to weave a basket. Weave in. And there we go. One's going to be for my food, and the other's going to be for my cook. How about that? All right, let's put my cook kit in. What's in my cook kit? Let's find out. This is a MRS, NNYPO, whatever. I have a lighter. It was a spork, but I'll change it. And my little gas stickety thing. Then I have my gas in the Green Cup Society. Come join us for the Green Cup Society. Don't be afraid. All right, my two cups. Yeah, I didn't know how important these are until I was at the Rhineville and holding my hot ass tin cup was worse than holding it.
I'm getting stung by bees or something.
All right, that's gonna be my cook kit. Look up some. That is my cook kit. Bag now. I'm glad I got this little whatever case this is, a rocket case. Or... Now, what's going to be in this bag is going to be my food rations. Let's go get them. I want to protect my food with a dry sack. Why is that, Ranger Kooky? You ever ate soggy food before? You ever had mashed potatoes already made in your bag? Or how about some rice that's been made already in your bag before you get to eat it? Darling Paul and Annie got me hooked on these chicken packets. Oh, man. Thank you, Donnie. Mama loves you. Donnie beats me sometimes. I think I got too much food for this one bag. So I might take the rest and see if I can throw it in another bag. Alright, there you go. A dry sack for my rations. Because, I don't know, would you like to have wet, soggy food? It's like eating, it's like fixing yourself a bowl of dog food. Here's some dog food. Might be a little soggy there, little puppy dog. Oh shit, isn't that gonna fit? Damn you, boy. All right, I guess we can do a trade out. Since this is gonna be easy to take out than in. So let's do a little trade. Let's put the cook kit in the top. There we go, fine, have it your way. always Burger King. Now, watch how easy the food's gonna go in there. Now, look up a little bit. There you go. Now. There you go. Done. Now, what can we do over here? Well, we got a flashlight, a knife, and a saw to put on our bag here. My precious. So, what we're going to do is, let's go to the front. The front looks so naked now. I don't like a naked bag. Look how naked it is. Look, it's naked. It don't look right. Alright, so I guess I go ahead and put my saw, time chipwood knife, and my little pocket knife. Just to have something on here. Alright. Put a small light. Even though it's just bitty mat light, have good to have on your bag. Because you know where your bag is. You just have to get to your light. Pain in the ass, but it's worth its in value. That's why they're made that way. So it'll give you a long-lasting bag. And not a piece of crap you find at Walmart. That's right. Walmart sells crap. No good Molly's at Walmart. If they did, I'd be buying them. Oh. There we go. Here's the front side. I got my cook kit. No, my food. My cook kit. Now the front. And this comes open. Comes open. Listen to me. And I can grab my saw, my knife, my other knife, and my Molle if I need it. And the other side, which I don't know where I'm going to put in this bag yet. But I could put all kinds of stuff on this thing. I could put that there. I could put this there. I don't want to put that there because it's not made for that. Damn boy. Well, that's the same bag. I could put my emergency blanket on there again. Just to have it, I guess. And I could put this in the front because it's... I don't know how. There's no Molle buttons. I can pull these bags up front if I wanted to. And then I got this crazy description. I don't know how to put this on something. But I got a little strap there. Alright, I'm Ranger Kooky. I hope you enjoy this video of the Molle 2. And how I like to do things. All right. Buckle all your straps on your Molle. Helps a lot with your back support. All right, see y'all later.